Hey y'all, I'm Miss Katie. Welcome to Heritage Ways IGTV. And I want to show you inside this quaint little building. I want to tell you what's inside of it, but I think you're going to recognize my friend because she is your friend on Instagram too. So y'all come on and let's look inside. And are these geraniums not beautiful? Oh my word, they're so beautiful. We're in Texas today. I was just telling them they're going to recognize my friend, Shawn. She's hey, from y'all. The Lone Star Barn.
From the Lone Star Barn, yes.
Right here on Instagram.
I'm so glad you're here.
Yes. And so what is going on with Little Miss Homemaker?
Little Miss Homemaker is making a spring wreath to take home.
Yes, and it's bright and colorful. She loves orange and yellow.
Yes. She picked that from all the ribbon. That's what she picked.
So what is this? What are you doing here?
So this we lovingly refer to as the Wreath Barn.
Okay.
Like I told you before, I kind of started this hobby and it took over my daughter's bedroom after she left for college, and then it grew to the family room and the pool table, and finally my husband said enough. We're going to get you your own little portable building on the ranch. Okay. So
and this is
this
awesome.
Is the Wreath Barn.
This is awesome.
Keep going.
And you make and sell wreaths.
I do. I make predominantly custom-made wreaths.
Okay.
Every now and then I put something, you know, up for sale that doesn't have an owner yet, but most everything I do is custom work. So people call and tell me what they're looking for, or maybe send me pictures of ideas they have, and we kind of create it. Get the design idea going together and go from there. Yeah.
All right. Well, how can somebody, you said people call, but like, do you have other avenues where people
I do,
can see
absolutely,
your work?
On Facebook, The Lone Star Barn, and that's kind of a combination, my family page and my work page as well. So you might see ranch stuff and a little college football and a little family life and my wreaths. And then on Instagram, I am Lone Star Barn without the V.
Okay.
And same thing, just a lot of different family things, but also the wreaths are there too. And so you can private message me at any of those locations and we'll just start working on something together.
You do great work. And you know what? They could go on your Instagram feed because you have lots of your wreaths on there, don't you?
Yes, in my Instagram stories, there's a highlight called Wreaths, and that's just a lot of my most recent.
Good.
Let me get that. Okay, now keep going.
Now, I saw a wreath. This is left over from one you just did, and you delivered to a lady the other day.
Yes.
An Easter wreath,
she came and picked it up
beautiful.
On Friday. It was an Easter lily wreath with a cross.
It was beautiful.
The white cloth on it. So
you've got all kinds of inventory to fill, all kinds of requests.
I do.
So what is the most unusual one that you've ever made for a customer?
Okay, I've done two that are sort of unusual. One lady, if you're familiar with the San Antonio area, there's a big celebration in San Antonio called Fiesta, and different businesses and families and some of the Fiesta royalty give away medals.
Okay.
And a friend of mine had collected medals for years and years and years, and they're lapel type medals, and she wanted wreaths made out of them. So we did two big metal wreaths for her, and when I say metal, I mean metal pins.
Okay.
That were just all Fiesta medals for her double doors with big bright bows, and so that turned out neat. And then another one, I actually had a male client who wanted a golf wreath for his office.
Okay.
So that was a little unusual. And then I've done a bass fishing wreath for a professional bass fisherman from here in the area. So.
Do you happen to have those photos on the Instagram highlights, or?
I know for sure they're both on Facebook. I'm not sure if they're on Instagram, but I'll go back.
I'm
and
thinking
check
the metal one that you did is
yes,
on
those are for sure. Okay. The two, the fishing and the golf. I'm not sure. I'll have to double check. But
now, what's your busiest time of year? Is it Christmas, or would I be? Is it another time of year?
Well, it is. It is Christmas and fall.
Fall.
Everybody
fall.
Likes the fall.
Fall's my favorite
the
season.
The Thanksgiving wreath. Yeah,
so
it's probably one of my favorites to do.
Yes.
So from about back to school, about September through December is a really busy time.
Okay. Did you teach yourself? Like, this is a gift, isn't it? You do a great
I
job.
Did. I made something for myself and just happened to snap a picture and put it on Instagram, and somebody said, can I buy one and how much? And I said, yeah, you can.
Yeah. And that's how a lot of businesses get started. So, okay. And the last question I have, okay. If somebody is out there in our current world climate right now, and they're at home, but they have access to ordering online.
Yes.
Okay. And they think, well, I might want to make one wreath at my house. Okay. I just want to dabble in it.
Okay.
So can you give them two or three suggestions, maybe somewhere they could go online, or maybe a couple of just basic things to start with, just to see if they like it, or just to have something to do at home?
Absolutely. First of all, Little Miss Homemaker and I are doing something really simple, and this is just a styrofoam wreath wrapped in ribbon, and we're going to embellish it with some flowers here, but it doesn't get much simpler than this. The online resources are really plentiful. There is a online resource called Deco Exchange, and he is a gentleman wreath maker, an entrepreneur, huge businessman, and has lots of how-to videos, free videos, a blog, a YouTube account. So DecoExchange.com would be a great place to just find online resources.
Great. Yeah. Thank you for sharing that information. But also, if they say, I don't have a wreath making bone in my body, they can just peruse your Facebook account.
Yeah, go to my Facebook
Instagram.
Account. What a lot of people do is go to Pinterest and see things that they like and send me a picture. And I say, I won't duplicate that exactly, but I'll make something very similar. And we kind of go back and forth on the design ideas, which is the part I like the most, is the customizing.
Yes.
Taking a customer or a client's idea and making it come
it
to
real.
Life.
Well, thank
so,
you, Ms. Shawn.
Pinterest is a great resource to see what your style is and what you like.
Yes.
And then talk with somebody about making it for you.
Pinterest is awesome. Yeah. I'll have to say. That's true. Well, thank you so much for sharing this.
Thank you for coming. This is her first
wreath, by the way.
Well, you need to come back and see it when it's finished.
Okay.
We'll send a picture when it's all finished.
Okay. We'll post a picture or something. That sounds great.
All right. Thank you for coming by.
Thanks so much. All right.
Bye, y'all.
Bye, y'all.